I'll be showing you today a method how to adjust the collimation of a LOMO MBC-10 microscope. That is a Soviet-made microscope, and it's very robust. And it uses a Galilei zoom system that is made out of small telescopes. There are several of these telescopes on a barrel, and when you rotate that barrel, you either have a magnification in the telescope, as it's shown now, or a minification. If you flip this, you will get the minification. So here is the diagram. We start with an object, the objective lens here. The beam paths get split in two for the left and the right eye. There's an option for a camera tube here, which we don't need, and we also don't need the eyepieces and that whole system of prisms that's around there. What I'll be doing is I'll insert a plus one close-up filter. What is that? That is a lens with a diopter of one. That means that the focal length is 1 meter, so, or 1,000 millimeters. And what this does, I've tried to show you in a diagram, is we have the light from our objective coming into the objective lens, into the zoom system, and then it's recombined again to an image up here. And whether, if there is a misalignment in one of these lenses, that will show up as an image that is double, so you get double vision, like the microscope is drunk. And to adjust that, we shift these lenses from left to right or front to back, and that way we can adjust the two images to coincide with each other. And we can check which lens we need to adjust by blocking one system, or one beam path, I should say. So if you block the right beam path, we see the effects of the left beam path, and vice versa. So before we start aligning this microscope, let me just give you a little walkthrough of what we got here. This is a LOMO MBC-10. That is a Soviet-made microscope. They're very robust, also a bit clunky. But yeah, overall I like them. They're not too expensive. There's a little knob here to adjust the pupil distance between these two tubes. There are two eyepieces in here. This microscope is very easy to disassemble. You can just loosen this screw and then take a part off. So you can see here the optics that are in here. This is the head. This here is a phototube attachment that is not necessary. So yeah, this is just straight, and if you turn this lever, that is actually stuck now, so I need to repair that as well. Two prisms slide in, and then the beam is 50% of the beam is then directed towards this tube, and you can put the camera here, and then you can take pictures and videos. This is the main body where everything attaches to. This is the focus knob here. This is the zoom function. You can see why I call this a clunky microscope, because it clicks to every setting. This is the objective. You can also take that easily off. And let me show you this head, because this is what we're going to adjust. This here is the head that does the zooming. Here is a I don't know if that shows up. Not really. Light that properly for you. Yes, that's much better. So there's a little number here, number 2. I don't know if that shows up, but there's a number 2 there. And at setting number 2, so 2 times magnification, there's no optics in there. See, there's just holes here. So by default, the microscope has a magnification of 2 times. If I would put this objective straight through the eyepieces,
So if I were able to attach those, then I have 2x magnification. Now they call this the Galilean zoom system. That is some Greek scientist from way back, and he invented a type of telescope. And these are actually little telescopes in there, because the objective collimates the light. So the image, so your object is imaged to infinity, and these telescopes, they will magnify that in that collimated space, as that's called in optics. So you have all different types of settings, 0.6, 4x, that's 2x again, because this is a barrel that rotates. So you get the 2x settings actually 2x. There's also 7x magnification. And if I go back to the 0.6x magnification, that's 180 degrees. So if you have looked through a binoculars in reverse, you would have noticed that you actually have a minification. So this is the minification side. This is the binoculars looking through the binoculars at the wrong direction. And this is the binoculars at the proper direction. You can also see that, because this will be the objective of a binocular, so the front lens, and this will be the eyepieces. And see how they're smaller? Small eyepieces, large objectives. And what the problem is that one of these lenses is misaligned. So, I don't know if that shows, yeah, this is better. So one of these lenses are misaligned with respect to the other. And I'm going to show you how you can align that and resolve that problem. So this is the microscope without the close-up filter. This is with filter. The position of the filter is not so important. I will move it now. You see that only the image moves a little bit. This is a 2x magnification. That means that there are no lenses in place. And when I block one of these paths, which I do now, then you only see that the light will change in intensity. The image will change in intensity. Now if I go to 4x magnification, see that the image is in a little bit different spot. That's not so important. So when I start to defocus, you will see actually here some speck of dirt, but also that there are two images starting to appear. And when I block one, you will see that then one image is missing. And if I block the other one is missing. I can bring it into focus, and now it's one nicely concentric, or what you will, image. And if I block one of them, you see that only the intensity varies. And if I block the other one, the same happens. Now if I go continue, oh, that is the wrong way, sorry. Now I'm at 7x magnification. Now the image is at a different spot again. I will recenter it by moving the flashlight. You'll see now that this image is blurry. If I block one part of the image gets better. You can actually see here on the side that the width changes. And then I see one crisp line here, and these bars, that's the structure of the LED, the LED. And here you will see, you see two lines now, if you look closely. I don't know if that shows up on camera. Here you see one line, two lines, and if I block the other path, you will see this line. See, so this shows me that this is out of collimation, or the rays are not parallel. If I try to focus this, then nothing changes really on one path, so I'm blocking the right path now. I block the left path, try to focus, that changes a little bit. Now I want to go back to the same focal point as I had with 4x magnification, so I'm now at 4x magnification. Focusing this, go back to 7. That's here. We see two images. I will try to refocus this to see if the if I need to correct the focus as well. So there's a marginal change. I don't know if that's depth of field, depth of focus from the microscope, or actual a faulty collimation. So I have to I have to investigate that while looking through the microscope. But first we can do something with the parallelity of the beams, and that is something I want to do now. I know I have messed up this scope before I started this exercise by only adjusting the left path. So that is the path I'm blocking now. And that is also the one that I will be adjusting. And I will show you that to you on video. So before we can adjust the beam paths, we need to remove the close-up filter. I'm going to loosen each screw and then tighten it a little bit. I'm trying to be very careful not to break these screws, because then I have an even bigger problem. So, now I will position my light again. Position the filter, just to check how this is positioned. I'll block one of the beam paths, so you can see this above. But I'll block one of the beam paths and then see that the image here is a little bit too much to the right. So this lens has to go to the left to correct it. So the image that you that I see on the ceiling here is too much to the right, so I have to adjust to the left. So I got a watchmaker's hammer and a piece of a skewer. And now I'm going to lightly tap that to the left. See if I can adjust that. So I placed the close-up filter again and then blocked the image to see if there's anything changed. Sometimes I'm blocking it halfway to see whether the image, then you just can see it lightly coming in, if that makes sense. And then, that helps with looking at it.
I think it's getting closer. I think also the screws are still a little bit too tight. I'm going to loosen them and then tighten them a little bit less. Okay. Gonna give it a little, just two taps maybe. I'm not sure if I can see it getting better, so I'll try to tap it more. I think that moves now. I'm seeing very little change. I'm seeing no change. So I'm going to loosen these even more, these screws. Half a turn. This one feels loose. This one feels loose as well. Okay, this one feels loose as well. Let me check now. Oh, oops. Yep. So I think it moved. Let's check. Yes, now something has changed. So this is good. We are actually adjusting it. But it's moving the wrong way. So now I have learned that when the image is right, then the lens needs to go to the right. So, we tap it the other way. Oh, ooh, now we... I saw it moving there as soon as I touched it. Okay, so I need to tighten the screws a little bit. Just only using two fingers, my thumb and my index finger on the screwdriver to tighten it. And I'm very light. Okay. So maybe my conclusion of a few moments ago was wrong. So let's see what we have now. Blocking the right path. You see the image is too much to the left and too much towards me. So I think I need to tap it. Sorry, I think I'm saying it wrong. Let me say that again. Yeah, the image is towards me and to the left. So I think I need to tap it away and to the right. Away from me, that is, to the right. So I'm going to choose the diagonal here. Just a few taps. Yeah, that's getting there. Maybe first to the one that is largest. So the largest deviation is from in this direction. Blocking it with my hand now, so I don't have to pick up the paper.
think I'm going the wrong direction. So I'm trying to stepping it back now. And so it move. Let's see what that does. That is in the proper direction. So that's the direction I need to go. Okay, now I need to go to the right, I think. No, this is the wrong direction. Okay, I'm getting there in from left, the left to right direction. Now I need to go from front to back. And I think I need to tap it towards myself, so I'm going to try that. Okay, this is closer. This is closer. So that attempt on aligning actually moved it from side to side. So I'm getting the feeling that this is going to be a little bit fiddly, but I have no other method, so I'll do my best. Okay, so I'm almost there. So this LED has bars in it, the structure of this LED, and I see there's almost a quarter of a bar in error. Let me show that to you. Let's see if I can get that on camera. Okay, focus. Oh. Yeah, okay. So it's hard to man all the devices here. But if I block this side, you might be able to see that there's that line. It's almost quarter of a bar. And when I talk about the bar, let me block one path here, so I can point that to you. When I'm talking about a bar, I mean this one. So this is actually where the electrical contacts are of these LED, and these are the structures that give light. Okay, so back to our microscope. There is still some high-tech equipment on there. Let me remove that. Okay. So the image I'm seeing is towards me. The image of the left path is too much towards me. So I need to tap it towards me to compensate it, as I've learned just now. So let me just give it a very light tap. Okay. So you need a light hammer for this. That's why I need use a watchmaker's hammer. If you use a claw hammer, then you won't succeed. Okay, so I'm getting closer. I'm getting closer still. Okay, so I'm almost there. That makes it harder for me to judge which way I need to move. Let me show that to you. The level of alignment that we're in now. Okay, let's focus. So when I block the right beam path, now you see that they're almost, they almost coincide. So it's blocked, unblocked, blocked, unblocked. See the auto shutter adjusting there of the camera. So I got the feeling that it's a little bit the left path needs to move that way, to that direction. Because I see the edge of that image disappearing there on the left. So yeah, left over left and right is a little bit confusing, but I use my own left and right. Okay, let me check again which is left and right. Okay, so I think I need to adjust it a little bit towards me and a little bit towards the right. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the diagonal here, roughly 45 degrees, and tap it again. If I look up, I can actually see the image move. Let me just remove this paper because this might even make it more clear. Looks like the image might be a little bit defocused. I'm going to tap it a little bit more. That was maybe way too much. I think I'm quite happy with that. Now I'm going to check it by installing the head on this microscope. Luckily that's very easy with this microscope. Let me zoom out for you so you can see that. Now the head is installed. I will get two eyepieces. 8 times eyepieces. So, and if everything is alright, then I'm already in focus of that LED, so I don't have to adjust my focus. Let me adjust my desk lamp here. Not sure if I can see that. Yes, I see the LED. Oh, there's also a lens on the LED. So maybe that influences everything as well. I'm first going to check at a lower magnification to see if the head is adjusted correctly. With that I mean the pupil distance. So I'm wearing glasses and that makes it difficult for me to use these standard eyepieces because they have little eye relief. So I have the feeling that is okay, that the alignment is good. Maybe I need to look at something else here. There is some hole here on this flashlight. Yeah, I have to adjust the eyepieces a little bit. Okay. This looks good, but this is 2x magnification, so this is without the zoom lenses in there. This is 4x magnification. That looks good. This is 0.6 magnification. I think that's good. This is 2x magnification again, of course that's good. This is 1x magnification. Yeah, that's also good. This is 7x magnification. This is the one that will be the most sensitive to the errors. And I got the feeling that is reasonably well. Reasonably okay. So now I have removed the head and I want to check again with the flashlight here. If everything is okay. Put my close-up lens on it again and focus it. Focus nicely to one image. I'm going to block a path with a piece of paper. Yeah, maybe. Now I'm moving the flashlight a little bit to see if that influences the measurement. I'm blocking again. I think one image is slightly defocused from the other one. But I'm not sure. Yeah, I think slightly, but that will be hard to adjust. I didn't notice it while looking through the scope. Okay, so I'll focus it on the right path. At least let me check on the 4x magnification. If I focus it on this magnification. And then go to 7x again. Yeah, so I think the left path is out of focus. So I'm going to switch to 4 again, go to my reference, and then to 7. And then I have to focus that. And that's not so easy. Because there are these small nuts in there, and you need a special spanner for that, and that I don't have. So I'm going to do something terrible here. Do it with a screwdriver. And I actually need to take this ring out. I've already done this when I messed the alignment up. So I have to take this ring out. And then I have to get an idea how to focus it, and in which direction I have to turn. So I would say I need to turn in, but that's only on gut feeling. So clockwise is moving in, and here is one of these tabs, so I'm going to move it quarter of a turn in. And I'm judging the image again. And I think that actually made it worse. Yes. So maybe I can. That's. Maybe I can lock one path with my finger and then try to adjust it. No, oh, but I'm also adjusting that with that line, so that's not a good idea. Okay, I'm going another quarter of the turn in the opposite direction. This makes it better, I think. A quarter of a turn. So I still see a slight misalignment of that lens, the left lens. So I'm going to tighten this because I think focus is okay now. I'm just tapping that lightly with my thumb. Okay. Let me check again. Oh, now the images are aligned again. I think that the lens just needed to be tightened and now they're back in alignment again. So let me show you that on the screen. Come up. Okay. So I think it looks a little bit blurry on the phone here. But I can see it clear. But what's the main thing is whether these images are aligned. And now I'm blocking the right path. I see only a difference in illumination. So in the brightness of that image. And I see a little bit changing here. But when looking at this line here, I see nothing changing. So I don't see the position changing there. I'm blocking. I look here at this line. Blocking. So I see no change there. If I block the left path, so that's the other light path, I look at these lines. Block, unblock. Block. When I go slowly through this image to the blocking and I kind of dim the other image, that's what I'm doing now, slowly. You can see a dark band moving through that image, at least I can. I don't know how that shows up in the camera. But this is now aligned. So if you now check all the states, so this is 2x zoom. This is a very nice image. If I block one path, you only see the light, but there's no optics now in between the objective and the filter, the close-up filter. So this should be always good. And this is 4x zoom. Block, unblock, block, unblock. So that's good. 0.6 zoom. If I block this, yeah, I see a little bit deviation there. I see, yeah, so this is very small. Because this is a minification. Is that actually showing up? Oh, that's off screen for you. Okay. Here we are. Oh, that's too bright. That is too bright. But I see a very little deviation there. So I don't know if I can even adjust that. This is 4x zoom. Let me put that in view for you. Let me put that target back so I know where to point. Zo. So this looks good. This looks good, but this is 2x again. This is 7x. I go through focus, I can't get the focus better. So I think this is all right. This is one time magnification. Block, unblock, block, unblock. So that's okay. This is two times again. This is the 0.6 again. So yeah, there's a very small deviation there. But you cannot see that on the camera, I'm afraid. No. Okay, so that's it. That is aligning a LOMO stereoscope type MBC-10 with a hammer and a skewer. Thanks for watching.